Yo, what's
your
up?
Your fix.
Metal injection.
Breathe very bit.
Johnny Orlando Jr. preparing your dose of metal injection here with Between the Buried and Me. How you guys doing today? They're here at the lovely New England Metal Fest. What is the greatest misdirect you guys have ever seen?
So far, this interview, because I was under the impression it was going to be cool.
Right.
But apparently that didn't work out.
Right.
Nah, I'm just kidding. I don't know. What's the greatest misdirectest? Can often happen, like, if you're driving and there's a detour.
Yeah.
Construction.
Yeah.
Like, you thought you were going one way.
Yeah, you thought you were going one way. You end up going another way due to construction.
Right. And you guys encounter a lot of construction on the road, clearly.
Yeah. So much that we made a concept record about it.
I like that.
Yeah.
So how is your construction job going?
Pretty good. I just got a new backhoe
and a
bobcat. Putting in a swimming pool at my old man's house.
Good.
Yep.
It's important.
It's going to have a diving board and some floats and some fun noodles. So we're going.
So you're just going to bury a bathtub in the ground then?
More or less, yeah.
Okay.
And
And
I'm going to put my goldfish in there too.
Between the Buried and Me loves goldfish. Is there any particular brand that you guys endorse? Do you have a goldfish endorsement?
Pepperidge Farm.
How has new wave polka grunge evolved since the release of Colors?
Has it? I think it's.
I think it hit its peak there.
Yeah.
Right? And there's no evolution to be had.
We know that. I mean, it's fairly common knowledge that you guys are named after a lyric in the Counting Crows song. Why do you listen to the Counting Crows?
I'm not ashamed to say it. I think they're a great band. Great lyrics. Great music. They've written some timeless albums, man.
I have no comment. I wasn't in the band when they came up with that title. I personally think it's really stupid.
But they pay you well, so you stick around.
They do. I do it solely, yes.
Glass Casket. Good band name.
Yeah, we actually stole that name.
Oh, really?
That's actually my next question. You guys have, is it Giles or Giles?
Giles.
Giles, right? And then you got Glass Casket, Orb, and the Jacob Rogers clothing line.
Yeah.
How does this non-committal nature manifest itself in your personal relationships?
We don't spend any time on any of that stuff, ever.
We start the project and then just not finish it.
We just don't have time.
Yeah.
We would like to think we could possibly have time to do something else, but we don't.
Right.
So. Like, I'm in a side band called Inner Bargain, and we've never done anything.
Have you practiced?
No.
That's important. That's important to know. So as long as you guys just have a name for your side project, then it's legit, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Would you guys rather tour with Cher, Madonna, or dead Michael Jackson?
He would be dead?
Yes.
Dead Michael Jackson.
Yeah.
What would the performance of the dead Michael Jackson be like?
I'm not an artist, so I can't really say. I can say that it would be amazing. Yeah.
It'd be like Weekend at Bernie's.
Dead body out there.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
Weekend at Bernie's.
I guess we do that.
Yeah,
we
do.
Out there and just play his records. Man.
Yeah.
Right.
And
so you guys would prefer to actually be the support band for dead Michael Jackson?
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. Dude,
yes.
Any form of Michael Jackson.
Yeah.
Right. What are you guys going to do right after this interview?
I've been holding in a fart almost this whole time, so I'm probably going to do that.
Would you like to allow everyone to hear it?
What the fuck?
And you've gotten your fix of metal injection with Between the Buried and Me.